In this video, I will show you how to copy your Windows to SSD drive. If you're a laptop user or a desktop user, you have to skip some part of my video which might not be relevant to you, but the rest of the video should be relevant to both the users. Please follow me step by step and you should be okay. Obviously, you would need an SSD drive. If you're planning to install it to your PC, you need a bracket to mount it for place which holds HDD. If you got a laptop, you still can do the same thing, but you need an external docking or adapter so that you could mount SSD to this and then back up the data or transfer or clone the data from your Windows to the SSD. So let's get started. So let's open the casing. So you should have your original HDD drive already installed, and we got another slot for installing our SSD drive. So this is the SSD I got. This is from Kingston and it is 450 GB, which is approximately the same size as my HDD drive. So we need screwdrivers, we need some screws. So we got our SSD and the bracket, align them. So the holes of the bracket would be in line with the SSD. Also make sure that the disk cut at the back of the bracket would be in the front where the wires will go in. So you don't need to make them too tight. It's not under a lot of force, but it should be tight enough so that it will not face a lot of vibrations. So I have screwed all the four screws. Make sure they are tight. I strongly recommend you touching the back, the metallic part of your computer. This can take the static away from your body if you don't have the static wrist. So now it's really simple. I got four places that some kind of thing like a screw sticking out. So one side is fixed, the other side is flexible, as you can see. So we need to first put the side that's fixed into the four holes and then pull back and it will go in pretty easily. As easy as that, we have mounted now our SSD. Look at how tiny it is, and it's secure quite well with this bracket. The bracket came with a lot of screws which I didn't need. So my current HDD has got two wires connected, and from the same branch of wires I take two wires, and now one is SATA and one is for power. So I connect to my SSD. First connect the big one and then connect the other one. It can only be fitted from one direction. Don't try to force it in if it doesn't go in. Just try the other side. So as you can see, now we have connected our SSD. It's also very important to make sure that other end of the SATA cable is connected to your motherboard. Now we can just easily put the casing back. If you have a laptop, it's better to connect the SSD drive to a special docking and then clone it. Even if you don't have an laptop, you still can use this same method. So now I would be turning on the computer. Now we have physically connected our SSD to our motherboard, whether you have connected using an adapter or you have connected using an internal slot. Now this step would only apply for desktop users and not laptop users. So if you got a laptop, you can skip forward. But if you got a desktop, what you got to do now is to go to your BIOS. Different computers have different method to get there. Then go to your drives, and then go to again drives, and make sure your other drives are checked. All the drives, because it doesn't really show what other drives are at the moment. Once you have done it, click apply. Exit. Then you might get a message like this. Press F1 to continue. So now our computer is started, and if you go to your this PC, you might not see your added SSD drive, but you don't have to worry. I'm just gonna show you how you can make it to appear. All you need to do is to go to the start and type in partition. Once you type in partition, you should see create and format hard disk partitions. Just click on that. Then you will receive a message saying you must initialize a disk before logical disk manager can access it. Select disks. It is disk 3. And then we have two options: master boot record or GUID partition table. So I'll go with the first one because GPT partition style is not recognized by all previous versions of Windows. If your computer is quite old, I suggest try with MBR first. Then click on OK. Then if you scroll down, you will see disk 3 around 450 GB is unallocated. So now if you right click on it, you'll get three options. Span and strip would combine with other drives, but we want a new simple drive. So I'll select a new simple drive. Then we get to this wizard. Then click next. You can specify how much megabytes you want to allocate for this new drive. Don't forget that you can allocate all of it, or you can allocate some of it so that you could have another drive from the same hard disk. But I want the whole hard disk would have one drive, so I would accept the default value and click next. Then it asks you which letter you want it to be assigned. If you check, you can see all other letters are used, and what's not being used, you can let it be by default and then just click next. Then it would ask you which type of file system you want. I will just go with the default, and it would ask you to give it label name. I would say SSD, and then I click on next, and it gives you a summary of the settings we have selected, and just click on finish. Here it is. Disk number 3 is now allocated. You can just close this, press window and E. Then if you go to your this PC, you can see the new SSD drive is installed successfully. Next thing we need to do is to clone our hard drive. To do that, you need to go to this website called EaseUs.com. I will provide the link in the description below, and there you can find two different versions. One is free, one is home, which you have to buy, but the free version should be enough for our task. So just click on free download. It will ask you to enter your email and click try to do backup free. Then click on download, save it somewhere in your PC, then double click to install it. You can click on custom install. I will remove this, agree to participate. Then you can check your backup path and select the SSD drive that we just added and click on OK. So this is our backup path, and installation would be on the C drive. Then click on install, then again click on install free. So then just click on start now. I checked my email and I didn't receive any emails to get the license code. So you can just press later. So make sure you close everything in your computer. And then if you click here, you can see a place called clone. Just click on that. So it will ask you the source. Obviously for us, the source is the C drive where everything is installed. Check that and then click on next. And this is really important. So now click on advanced options. And it's very important to select optimize for SSD. And then click on OK. This is very important to pay attention which hard drive you are clicking on. It is important that you select the hard drive that's completely empty. And also make sure the size of the hard drive matches the source or bigger. So I select the whole hard disk tree, which is the one that we recently just purchased, and we are planning to clone. Remember, this would be erased. Whatever data is there would be erased. So don't accidentally check on any other drive, because you will lose all the saved information there. Then click on next. Again, one more time, check C drive is what the source wants to be, and which is disk 0, and disk 3 is the F drive. I suggest you to go to this PC and check your C drive is what it says and F drive is what it says. After checking everything, it will tell you how much free space the source got and how much free space the target got. It's approximately the same, so we can proceed. It's not showing any red or anything. After you click next, you shouldn't use your computer. You should leave it for, it might take you a few hours depending on how big is your computer. Also make sure that your computer doesn't go to sleep. So go to the settings, go to the power and sleep options, and then go to the sleep. And the screen, it doesn't matter, but the computer itself, choose the option that it would never go to sleep when it is plugged in, or even if you got a laptop, even if it's not plugged in, just to be sure, put this to never, then close this. And now you should be ready to press proceed. But once you press proceed, don't use your computer, because everything you do would affect your C drive. So now I click proceed, and then it will give you a warning that the data on the destination disk would be lost. So you click yes. It took 6 hours and 21 minutes for the cloning to complete, and now you can see the cloning is finished. and disk clone completely successfully. There was an option to shut down the computer when the operation is complete, so you could just leave your computer on and take this option to it to complete. So it took a really long time, so leaving it overnight to clone, maybe it would be a good option. So just then click on finish, never ask again, close, press WE to open. And now if you go and see the drive that I cloned, it's called exactly the same. If you remember, I changed it to SSD, but now it is called local disk, which is same as the C drive. So everything inside should be exactly the same as my C drive.
This step depends whether you're a laptop user or a desktop user. If you're a laptop user, you have to shut down your computer now, take out the SSD drive from the adapter and replace the original hard drive from the laptop with the SSD drive and then turn on your computer. But if you're a desktop user, you have to restart your computer. We need to get to the BIOS system.
Just make a note of SATA 3 and 4 that are not found so we can uncheck them. So we go to the drives, we go to here drives. First make sure what's known and what's not. You can see here SATA 2 is okay, 3 and 4 are unknown, so we can just uncheck 3 and 4. So far so good. And also we need to go to the boot sequence, which is here, and change it so that Kingston would be at the top. So select Kingston and put it at the top. Just to be sure, you can uncheck your original hard drive, so we know now it would just boot from our SSD drive, and then go on apply, click exit. Well, here it is, the computer is started. So now if you go to your this PC, you can see the C drive, but the other drive, which was actually the original C drive, might have disappeared. In order to find it, press window, type in partition, and then you should find a thing called create and format hard disk partition. Select that, and here you should be able to see the C drive details, which is this. But if you look at our disk 0, which was the original C drive, now it doesn't have any drive attached to it. So if you click it, right click on it, and then click on change drive lateral path, click add, and then it will automatically detect an available letter, then click OK. So you got letter E. So in this way now you can access your original hard disk as well. So you can close this now, and you can see this was the original one. Double click, it's exactly the same as our C now. So easily and nicely we swap the SSD drive with the HDD drive, and you can see the Windows sign now appearing on the local C drive. First double check that this is the clone, and once you confirmed that your hard drive is cloned, now that we have successfully swapped, now you can completely format this drive and use it as an extra hard disk on your computer. But I will leave it for a few days to just make sure everything works and everything's there the way you want before I format the drive to use it. Or you can just use it the way you want, delete stuff from it to get extra space, because now we have duplicates.
I hope now you learn how to clone your Windows to your SSD drive. And if this video was useful, please don't forget to watch my other videos and subscribe. And I hope to see you in my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.